Hello everyone. Nowadays, Class D audio amplifier ICs are widely available and inexpensive. You can easily use them to build an amplifier. However, I don't highly appreciate their sound quality. About 15 years ago, I built several audio amplifier circuits using Class AB ICs, such as the TDA7294 and LM3886. Their sound quality was excellent, even though I used handmade PCBs. I'm planning to build a portable speaker with an integrated battery for camping, using the TDA7294 IC. However, this IC operates at an input voltage of up to size 25 volts, making it difficult to run directly on lithium batteries. We need to step up the battery voltage to 50 volts before supplying it to the IC. And that is exactly what today's video is about. Like many other projects, I am sharing this one in full, including the original files and Gerber files. You can download them and send them to a PCB manufacturer, or make the PCB manually if you prefer. You can also modify the PCB to fit your enclosure size or add other features if needed. Thank you to JLC PCB for generously sponsoring this project. JLC PCB is one of the leading PCB manufacturers in China and worldwide. Their PCBs are of very high quality and come at an affordable price. Production time is also very fast, usually under 2 days for standard PCBs. If they detect any errors or issues with your PCB, their support team is quick to assist you. You can also explore many other services from JLC PCB on their website, such as PCB design services, 3D printing, PCBA, and more. Additionally, they offer discount codes of up to $60. If you use Facebook, you can follow JLC PCB's page, where they frequently host mini-games with prizes in the form of discount codes for their services. About a week after placing my order, I received my PCB. As always, the quality was excellent. If you want to receive your order sooner, you can use DHL's service. It's faster, but also significantly more expensive. Next, we need to prepare the components for this project. First, you'll need two TDA7294 or TDA7295 ICs. I salvaged two from an old circuit, and I hope their sound quality will be good. We also need three large electrolytic capacitors, two for filtering the output voltage and one for filtering the 12-volt input voltage. Additionally, you'll need a few 10 μF electrolytic capacitors, resistors, and an FR508 fast recovery diode. All components are clearly labeled on the PCB, and they are easy to find at electronic component stores. This project uses through-hole components, making it very easy to assemble, even if you don't have much experience. The trick here is to solder the smaller components like resistors and diodes first, and then move on to the larger components like capacitors and MOSFETs. Use a soldering iron set to around 360 degrees Celsius and use solder with 2-3% flux. The most challenging part of this project is making the transformer. I used an EE33 transformer taken from an old ATX power supply, which you can easily buy from a store for around 1 to 1.5. The primary winding is made with 14 ABG copper wire around 2.5 millimeter squares. We need 3+3 turns for the primary side. The secondary is wound with about 9+9 turns using 22 ABG wire around 0.3 millimeter squares. Be sure to properly insulate both the primary and secondary windings. Winding the transformer doesn't require a lot of skill, so don't worry about it. The peak power of this circuit is not over 200 watts, so 4 MOSFETs are sufficient. In fact, you could even use just 2 MOSFETs and it would still work fine. You can use any N-channel MOSFET, such as the IRF3205, IRF4110, etc. Just don't forget to solder extra soldering material onto the power tracks to ensure they can handle high power levels effectively. Solder the 3 capacitors into place. Make sure the capacitors have a voltage rating of at least 35 volts and a capacitance of over 2200 microfarads. It's best to use capacitors with low ESR, equivalent series resistance, for optimal performance. Before installing the components for the audio section, we need to adjust the circuit's output voltage. A -30 V output is ideal. Adjust the potentiometer to achieve the desired voltage. If the MOSFETs are not heating up and the transformer is silent, then everything is working correctly, and we can proceed with the next assembly steps. Next, we will solder the TDA7294 ICs along with the surrounding peripheral components. This circuit includes integrated 15V power for the preamplifier section and a low noise 5V supply for the Bluetooth module. Simply install the components according to their labels and make sure to check the polarity of the capacitors carefully. The circuit's input voltage ranges from 11 volts to 16 volts, making it compatible with lead-acid batteries or 3S-4S lithium battery packs. Both work well. The output power will depend on the speakers you use. Keep in mind that the maximum power the IC can handle is 90 watts per channel, so choose your speakers accordingly. Good luck with your project!